Hey, this is Ben from 20mm, and today I'm going to unbox this huge and heavy box of Italieri, Stalingrad Siege 1942. It's box number 6193. Let's take a look.
Let's take a closer look at the packaging. So they call it a battle set with a tractor plant in 1 to 72 scale. As we can already see above here, will contain Russian and German soldiers. Expecting to see a T-34, Panzerfaust, some soldiers, maybe an SD-KFZ. Let's check out the content. So we got a pre-entry building of the tractor plant. Got the tractor plant itself, all MDF laser cut. Probably later cover in another video how to paint it. It's not so easy as normal painting. Got 50 German infantries, 48 USSR, Pak 40, six figures, Panzer 4F, 2x T-34, and some accessories. So cool that what was all in there. Here we get it in a little bit bigger view. Quite a huge building. Let's see, all the same information in different size. Just some commercials. Very cool. Let's check out also the price tag here was 65 euros. I think that's what I paid some time ago. And on the background we get some nice ideas how to build and how to paint it. I like the idea of bringing a real snow winter place to the tractor plant. Some trenches here, mortar teams, pre-building. I think it's a really cool thing. You can take it for playing Battle Group or any other tabletop game, or you can just use it as diorama. So a lot of work in just one box. And now I'm going to open it. So that's what we got when we open it. We get a nicely printed instruction. I'll come back to that later. Then we see our first sprue, so this is obviously the T-34, two of them, looks like an easy snap fit. This kit looks nice. Then same area we find our Panzer 4, also seems to have a very good quality. I built it already some of this easy fit models of Italieri. Always quite happy. Then we get some sets of decals, some signs here, Russian, turn it around, Russian ones. We also get some vehicle signs. What's always nice to check is if you have different numbers. Yes, you get different numbers for different vehicles. Nice, first to fight. Oh, this would indicate that we have some. Ah, that's not from this box actually. Funny, it's from another set. I'm sorry. Okay, let's continue. We have a huge sprue with infantry. In the center in gray, we see the Pak 40. And then we have Russian soldiers here in green. Oh, nice. We get some horses here. And this seems to be the machine gun from the Russians. We get some soldiers of Germany. Think I'm getting this out of the plastic bag to take a closer look. So let's check out the German sprues here. Pretty nice sculpting, molding. Also feel not oily. Pretty nice sniper pose, rifle pose, SMG. Grenade throwing is like always a little bit funny. commander, so we have multiple times this set. Then we got somebody carrying a mine. Like the rifle positions are quite fine. Some people crawling. Oh, we have a flamethrower, we have an MG34 here, some SMGs, some mortar, radio team, Panzerfaust. Nice. Looks very good. Happy with that, but I'm even more interested here in the Russian guys. Since I don't have any Russians yet, they're my first ones. The green plastic doesn't seem to be as good as the gray one. It's a little bit more shiny and sculpting is not as good as with the gray one, but still fine. Probably 7 or 8 out of 10. Poses is a little bit funny, he seems to be surrendering. This is an ammo belt. That's a nice. Let's flip it around here. You see the better ammo belt for the machine gunner. It's fine. And what I really like about this set is that we get some Russian horses. That will help us to create an interesting Russian starter army. Here we see the sprue of the anti-tank gun, PAK 40. Also quite nice quality. And some infantry, let's flip it around. Really cool sprue, happy with it. Finally, let's check out what's inside here and which is making the most weight. What is a laser cut MDF set from Sarissa's Precision? So our gaming group has some of them and we were always quite happy. Looks really like a cool structure. Let's see it in the back. Ah yeah, here you get the laser cut feeling and it also smells a little bit like laser cut MDF, which I like. So I will also cover this again in a how to build this video. And I think gluing is maybe not the problem, but painting it will be interesting since MDF is really sucking up the paint. To summarize the video, let's take a closer look at the instruction here with multiple languages. Quite nice format, all in color. It's also still not normal. And we see of which single packages it consists. So it's 6033 German infantry with some painting instruction, 6047 Russian infantry. We see the Panzer IV here, which comes with some decals, color instruction. Then we see the accessories, so we get some benches, some foregarden things, some lamps, freehand accessoires, interesting. So maybe another kit, or maybe it's in there. Then they give you some instructions how to build alloy things with Lego bricks. It's quite nice. Then how you can paint the walls. Pretty cool instruction actually, all in color, some nice tips. Now it doesn't want to open again. I have to expand here even more. So we have a T-34 instruction with decals. And we have the rest of the backside, which is showing out the entrance and some painting and instructions, administrative building. The plant itself. Let's see if we see any interesting painting instruction. Nothing yet seen so far. Yeah, pretty nice. Looking forward to really actually build this nice box. I think you get a lot of out of your 65 euros especially when you're a starter, this might be a good place to start. And if you like my video, give me a thumbs up and leave a subscription. See you the next time.